My name is Matangi Ramesh. I'm a senior product manager for IAM Access Analyzer. Customers often tell us that they really appreciate the fine-grained access controls that AWS has to offer. For example, with IAM, you can say what principal can take what fine-grained actions on what resources, under what conditions, and be really specific about it. Though customers like this flexibility, they want capabilities that simplify how they manage permissions. And that's how Access Analyzer came into being roughly in 2019. And over the years, we've added a few features to this toolset. So I'm here today to tell you about, talk about what IAM Access Analyzer has to offer, and also talk about how you can leverage these features to simplify your journey to least privilege. I'll quickly go through what kind of customer personas generally benefit from the features that Access Analyzer provides today, towards for what use cases, to achieve what goal, and I'll provide an overview of the features and give you some ideas on what kind of automation have we seen customers perform on top of the features that Access Analyzer provides. So who's the customer? When we see customers starting on AWS, they typically have an administrator who centrally manages all the permissions, grants everyone the required access, authors the policy, approves, disapproves, whatever permissions are being requested. What we see with customers is over time, when you add more accounts, this person ends up being the bottleneck. So we are seeing customers moving towards a decentralized approach to managing permissions. In this model, we have the development team on one end who is working on the application and managing permissions for those applications. On the other end, you have the security team who is invested in the compliance for the whole organization, is invested in ensuring that the teams follow security best practices. So I'll be talking about two personas here. One is Bob the Builder, who's focused on speed, who wants to ensure that the application goes to production fast, does not want to spend too much time figuring out the permissions, ideally wants features that they can automate identifying what permissions need to be granted. And on the other hand, you have Sarah, the security lead, who does not, who works at scale across all the accounts, does not want to individually manage permissions for single accounts, and is invested in security best practices and compliance. So what do these two personas want to do? Bob wants to ensure that the application functions, that's it. And Sarah wants to ensure that she wants to definitively answer who can access what. And this is a very point in time representation of how folks manage permissions. As teams change and workloads evolve, we see that the process of managing permissions is actually a cycle, more of a journey across setting, verifying, and refining permissions. So as Sarah sets the guardrail, as you set up accounts in AWS, Sarah would set the guardrails within which the team can function. And Bob would author permissions within those guardrails for their application. Over time, as Bob is granting those permissions, Sarah wants to ensure that whatever is being granted matches her intent or the security best practices that they want to set for their organization. And over time, Sarah wants to ensure that whatever access is being retained across the accounts is actually intended and just the required ones for the teams to take care of their functions. And so she asks Bob to routinely go in and fix the permissions to remove whatever is not required. So Sarah monitors access. Bob works hard to ensure the permissions are compliant with whatever the organization says, but towards what end? Simply put, it is to keep your system secure through the principle of least privilege. And what the principle says is that you grant your users and your systems the narrow set of permissions that they require to perform a particular task. Narrow permissions essentially means limited blast radius. In reality, what we see is that these personas want to maximize efficiency. They want least privilege, but they want to focus on their core business. And that's where Access Analyzer comes in. Access Analyzer does the analysis heavy lifting so that it becomes easier for you to set permissions and you can focus on what you really want to do with your business. I want to quickly pause here and ask how many folks have used Access Analyzer in the last couple of years? I see a few hands up. When I talk about Access Analyzer, it's really an umbrella of three features. To set the right permissions, Access Analyzer offers what's called policy validation. To help you verify permission intent, we have findings. And to help you refine unused access, there is policy generation. Let's start with setting the right permissions. So if there's a developer authoring policies, they can use Access Analyzer policy validation to ensure that the policy being authored is secure and functional. Imagine you are authoring a policy through the AWS console. So when you're in the process, a small window pane would open up below the policy. It could be in the IAM console, S3 console, IAM Identity Center. Wherever you're authoring that policy, what Access Analyzer does is it quickly runs over hundreds of checks based on what we think are security best practices, and it identifies possible issues with your policy and shows that in your in that window pane below your policy. This helps you without save time in figuring out what the possible mistakes or errors are and easily fix them. It provides you easy links that you can click on to figure out what changes need to be made. And the checks that Access Analyzer runs, based on it, it classifies the issues into one of these four buckets. An error is something that stops the policy from behaving as you intended to be. Policy validation also provides something called as a security warning, which if the issue exists, it might make the policy overly permissive. Then comes the general warning, which is based on some of the best practices that we thought of. And finally, to help you improve the quality of the policy, there are also recommendations or suggestions that you could optionally change in the policy. For example, if you have pass role with star in resource, it would show up as a security warning for the policy. So this is an easy feature that quickly provides you with some quick feedback on the policy that you're authoring. But if you, as a part of the central security team, want to ensure that everyone in your organization is using this and making updates based on the issues that are coming up, what you can do is you can easily incorporate this in your CI/CD pipeline and pass or fail the changes that are being pushed out based on the issues that show up. This is a great way for the dev team and the security team to sort of collaborate without investing too much time into it. And if this is something that you are interested in, then there is this neat blog that takes you through all the steps that show you how to incorporate the, basically call the APIs in your CI/CD pipeline. So give this a try. So once you, as you're authoring policies, the next stage, as I mentioned, is to ensure that whatever permissions are being granted matches your intent. And for this, Access Analyzer offers external access findings. What this feature does is it helps you identify what are the principles external to your account or to your organization that can access resources within your account. And it provides this information in the form of findings to help you easily identify unintended access paths from outside your zone of trust. So if you are interested in identifying external access to a selected set of accounts, you can set up Access Analyzer just for those accounts. And if you're interested in the whole organization, then you can log into your delegated admin account and set this up for the whole organization. What Access Analyzer would do is it would continuously monitor your environment. Whenever a new policy is added or a policy is being updated, if it enables any external access path, it would show that information up in the form of a finding. So if, say, Sarah was in the delegated admin account and she wanted to identify what are all the external paths available from outside the organization, the steps you'd want to take is create an analyzer through the Access Analyzer console. The moment you create it, the findings start showing up as you see on the screen. And what information the finding shows you is, it tells you who's the external principal, what resource can they access, what actions can they take based on what policy. So you can go through each one of these findings and figure out for yourself, is this access path required? If not, if it is required and you want to retain it, then you can archive the finding and just forget about it. And if you find something that should actually not be there in the first place, then all you need to do is update the policy that's being listed, and you can get rid of that access path. And Access Analyzer then notices that you made this change and automatically resolves the finding for you. I quickly want to talk about a few ideas on how you can automate on top of this feature. If continuous monitoring is something that you want, then Access Analyzer takes care of that. All you need to do is set up the analyzer, and Access Analyzer constantly looks for any policy updates and brings up the information to you in the form of findings. If you want to take immediate actions based on the findings that are brought up, then one thing that you can do is consume the Event Bridge notifications. So what Access Analyzer does is, the moment there's a new finding, it pushes it as a notification to Event Bridge. What we've seen a lot of customers do is consume these notifications on an ongoing basis and create tickets for their development teams to look into and sort of resolve the finding or archive the finding. And if you're interested in ensuring that these changes don't happen in the first place, then there is a subset of the feature called as Access Previews. And what this feature does is, it, whenever you're authoring a new policy, it tells you, if you were to put this policy into effect, what kind of external access would be enabled because of this policy. So it helps you preempt any external access even before the policy goes into effect. So we have seen some customers add capabilities to call Access Previews through their CI/CD pipeline to sort of block the changes if any new external access is being enabled in their organization or in their specific accounts. And finally, if you want to be more stricter with your rules and not make any changes possible for any external access to be granted, you can leverage CloudFormation hooks, make configurations to call Access Previews, and if there are any findings that show up for the updates being the updates that are happening, then the CloudFormation hook would fail and the update wouldn't happen. And this is another blog that talks about or shows you in detailed step how you can automate detection of public access for your KMS keys. So moving on to step three of the least privileged journey to refining permissions over time. For this, IAM offers a few capabilities today, which is based on the last access data that we find in CloudTrail. If you want to start broad at your guardrails level, for example, your service control policies, you can look at the last used information for all the services that are granted through your SAPs to identify what are the services that are not really being used and easily remove those or deny those in your SAPs to retain access to just the services that your teams require. The next step would be to dig a little deeper into your accounts to identify what are the roles or the users that are not being used. For example, you could look at the role last used information for each of the role in your account and say if some role is not being used in the last 90 days, you can, based on this data point, you can delete the role and reduce the access points to your account. Once you do this level of cleanup, the next phase would be to look at the permissions granted to your active roles. And for that, IAM, and more specifically, IAM Access Advisor, provides last accessed information at the service and the action level to help you identify what are the permissions granted to a role, when have these permissions being used, so that you can make permission updates based on this data. So if you're interested in using these features, for example, if you want to look at what permissions are being used by your role, you can go into your role detail page, look at Access Advisor, on this page, for example, it lists all the actions, EC2 actions that are granted to this role, and when each of those actions were last used. If you have folks who can't scale their review process to look at this data on an ongoing basis, Access Analyzer has a feature called policy generation that provides you a better starting point with your policies. What the feature does is it automates the review of CloudTrail for you and identifies all the granular actions that have been used in the recent past and generates a fine-grained policy. It also optionally adds a resource placeholder in those policies that makes it easy for you to say, okay, this is the resource to which this particular role can perform this action. It's just a placeholder today, but it tells you what's the format in which you need to provide the resource information in the policy, and you can easily update the variable information in there to further narrow down your policy. So if you're interested in this feature, what you can do is, like, all of these features are available both in the console and as APIs. If you want to use this through the console, what you would do is you would go to the role detail page, click generate policy, and you would take these three steps. First is to say, what's the time period for which you want Access Analyzer to review your CloudTrail? It could be anything between 1 to 90 days. And then you would select a trail in which you have your CloudTrail data so that Access Analyzer can analyze it for you. And finally, you would provide the required permissions for Access Analyzer to be able to do this. So once you provide these inputs, you can quickly hit generate, and the policy will be generated for you. The next steps would be to just review and create the policy. So for folks who want to ensure that their policies are narrow and just has the actions that are required for a particular role, this is a great place to start. And then you can customize this based on whatever security practices you want to follow. If you are a part of the security team who wants to automate continuously review the last access data to identify inactive permissions or inactive identities, you can use AWS config and do some of this automation. Set up a rule that gets triggered periodically that in turn invokes a Lambda function that goes through all the roles in your account to identify what are the inactive roles or what are the roles that have not been used recently. Based on this, you can ask your Lambda to sort of update the compliance in your AWS config and maintain the state and identify what are the roles or identities that are not being used, what are the permissions not being used, and be on top of this information. And there is another blog that talks about this more deeply. So if you're interested in doing this kind of automation, do check this out. And this goes into the detail of all the required steps you need to take to set this up for your environment. All right, I'll give you a quick recap of whatever we talked about. The first is to ensure that you author secure and functional policies. You can use Access Analyzer policy validation. If you want to identify what are the external access possible to your accounts, you use Access Analyzer findings. And finally, to start with a better starting point in terms of narrowly scoped policies, you can leverage Access Analyzer policy generation. Thank you all for coming here today. Please take some time to give us some feedback. And if you have any more questions on Access Analyzer, I'll be around here, happy to answer any of your questions. Thank you.